Hi, Trumpets, Mr. Y here, obviously, with a little tutorial today on the George Philip Telemann Fanfare. This is a level 3 trumpet solo. I'm going to be playing it today in euphonium. I apologize for that, but some of the higher notes are a little tricky for me on trumpet, so figured I'd give a better example on the euphonium. Couple things to worry about here. First of all, your key signature, obviously, is F sharp, so it's in G concert. It's in G major scale. You want to get familiar with the G major scale, obviously. That could be one of your scales that you're going to play for Nisman as well. There are a couple of F naturals scattered throughout, and a couple of C sharps also scattered throughout. It's a high C sharp, so it's 1 and 2 valve. F natural is, of course, first valve. F sharp, which are most of the Fs, is second valve, of course. There are a lot of other second valve notes in this song, too, because there's B naturals and that kind of thing, too. It does go up to a high G a couple of times. The high G above the staff, remember, is no valves at all. There's even a couple of high A's that go one more note above the staff, that little spaceship note up at the top. It looks like a UFO. That's an A, and that's first and second valve, really high A. Okay. You might want to get familiar with the G scale, you know, either the low version or the higher version, starting from there. Until you get that scale really in your fingers so you don't really have to think about it anymore, you probably don't want to attempt a solo like this. Lots of 16th notes also, so remember the 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a, each 16th note gets 1/4 of the beat. The tempo here is marked allegro maestoso. Allegro is fast, of course, but maestoso is majestically, so it's a little bit slower than your regular allegro. It's not really, really fast, kind of a regal kind of fast. I always think of majestically as like a king would walk, or like royalty walking into the room, that kind of thing. Okay, so I'm going to go about bum ba 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 bum bum ba 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 ba, about that fast. Okay, couple of dynamics. Forte most of the time. It goes down to mezzo forte at least once, I guess just once, and then the very ending is double forte. I'm going to put also a little ritardando right before the end. It's not marked there, but it does feel very natural to me to finish up in a big kind of way by slowing down just a little bit. Okay, so like I said, from the beginning, that's the G right there. Remember, all your stuff on trumpet is going to be an octave higher than this, but it is going to sound exactly the same. So use your ears, use your judgment. You'll be able to tell, I'm sure, if it's right or not. Okay, one and ready. Take things slow, take things a little phrase at a time, little chunks at a time, maybe just even 4 16th notes or a couple of 16th notes, that's fine. Work it in little parts, you know, just like my practice rule, work small to big, focus your energy, really, is what it is. Take little parts of it at a time and be methodical about it. Work on it a little bit every day, gradually add more and more to it or go farther in the song, that kind of thing. You shouldn't have too much trouble with this one if you're a level 3 player, okay? Any questions, of course, see me in class or drop me an email. I'll be glad to answer. Thanks.